morning and welcome back to my YouTube channel. As we have discussed colligative property and Ventor factor, today we will solve some numericals. Here I have four numericals for you. Let's solve one by one. The first numerical is find 1 molar NaCl solution exerts an osmotic pressure of 4.82 atmosphere at 27 degrees Celsius. Find degree of R dissociation. Value of R is given. So what to do? Write the given information. We have concentration 0.1 molar, temperature 27 degrees Celsius. If we change it to Kelvin, it will be 300 Kelvin. Value of R is 0.0821 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. And by using this data, we can find out Y equal to CR2. Y is the osmotic pressure. Concentration is 0.1 R, 0.0821, and temperature is 300. We can solve it. Easy calculation. 1 by 10, 0821, 4 decimals into 300. 3. So answer is calculation is 2.46 atmosphere. But we have provided the osmotic pressure value is 4.82. So it means it is observed value and it is a theoretical value. So pi theoretical is 2.46 and pi observed is 4.82. So by using this we can find out Ventor factor. How to solve? As we have studied, Ventor factor is observed colligative property by theoretical colligative property. And here we have two values, observed value as well as a theoretical value. So we can put it here, I equal to observed colligative property 4.82 and theoretical value is 2.46. If we simply solve it, it will come 1.959. This is a Ventor factor. Easy. But still we have to find out degree of a dissociation. How many molecules of NaCl get dissociated? So we have dissociation formula, degree of dissociation alpha equal to I minus 1 by N minus 1. I we have here 1.9519 minus 1. N is the number of ions given by ionic solute. NaCl will give 2 ions, so N is 2. So if you solve it simply, 0.959, that is degree of dissociation. If we have to find it in percentage, just simply multiply and alpha and percent equal to 0.959 into 100. So answer will be 59.59% NaCl get dissociated in this numerical, in this given equation. Simple. It is the first numerical. Same kind of numerical was in this year's CBSE chemistry paper. I show you. Almost same data is here. A solution contains 5.5 gram NaCl. Molar mass given per liter of solution. It has an osmotic pressure of 4.75 atmosphere at 27 degree Celsius. Calculate the degree of dissociation of NaCl in this solution. Just slightly data is changed. Here we have data 4.82 and here we have 4.75. The calculation, we will do this and we can find out the answer by simply using this equation, and we can find out the pi. easy. So one numerical is every year in a CBSE chemistry exam. Let's do next. Second is calculate the Van't Hoff factor for HF if the freezing point of 0.50 molar aqueous solution has a freezing point of minus 1 degree Celsius. So just use the data. We have molarity 0.50 molar. We have a freezing point of solution means TF equal to minus 1 degree Celsius. As it is aqueous solution, we know the freezing point of pure solvent is 0 degree Celsius. T naught F is 0 degree Celsius. This is the aqueous solution. So value of KF is 1.86 Kelvin per molar. So this is the depression in a freezing point numerical. As we have studied, delta TF equal to I into KF into M. I again is the Van't Hoff factor, and we have to find out the Van't Hoff factor. So this delta TF is simply find out by delta TF equal to T naught F minus TF. T naught F freezing point of pure solvent, TF freezing point of a solution. 0 minus minus 1 degree. So answer will be 1. Delta TF we have 1. Difference, difference temperature is 1. Delta TF 1. I find out KF 1.86, molarity is 0.5. We can solve it again. So 1 by 1.86 into 0.5 equal to I. So I equal to 100 into, sorry, 100 into 10 by 1.86 into 5. Is it 5 to 100 by 93? So answer will be rocks. 1.07. Easy. We can find out the Van't Hoff factor also by using simple colligative properties formulas. This is the second numerical. Let's solve third. Third is a weak electrolyte AB is 5% dissociated in aqueous solution. What is the freezing point of 0.1 molar aqueous solution of AB if KF is also given again? Is it? So again, this is depression in freezing point, and we have provided degree of dissociation. Alpha is here 5%, and molarity is 0.1 molar. KF is 1.86 Kelvin per mole, and we have to find out the freezing point of the solution of electrolyte AB. So we will use the formula again. Delta TF equal to I into KF into M, but we don't have I here, but we can find out I by using degree of dissociation. As we know, alpha equal to I minus 1 by N minus 1. I Van't Hoff factor, N number of ions or molecules given by solute. Alpha equal to 5%, so alpha is 0.05. I weak electrolyte AB, it will give 2 ions, A positive plus B, so N is 2. Sorry, I minus 1. N is 2 minus 1. So I here will be 1.5. Simple. I is 1.05. 1.05. is it? Now we can put it here. I 1.05 KF 1.86 molality is 0.1. Is it solid 105/100 186/100 into 1/10. We can multiply it and answer will come approximately 0.1953. This is the delta TF, but still we need to find out the freezing point of a solution. As we know, delta TF equal to T0F minus TF. T0F freezing point of pure solvent and it is aqueous solution, so its value is 0 degree Celsius. TF we have to find out freezing point of solution. Delta TF we have a calculator. 0.1953 equal to 0 minus TF. TF equal to minus 0.1953 degree Celsius. We can change into Kelvin also. That's the easy thing. You are 12 standard, you can do it. So this is the third variety. When electrolyte is given, degree of dissociation is given. Clear? I hope you are getting it. Next, move to fourth variety. Fourth is acetic acid associated to form a dimer. Dimer means it is association case. And we have given 1.6 gram of acid when dissolved in 100 gram of benzene, raised boiling point by 0.36 degree Celsius. Find Vento factor and degree of association. KF we have provided here. So use the data. What we have? We have weight of solute WB equal to 1.65 gram. We have WA weight of solvent 100 gram. And we have delta TB. Elevated temperature is 0.36. And now we have to find out I and degree of association when acetic acid associate to form a dimer. Here is a solute is acetic acid, its molecular weight is 60 gram. So by using data we can find out a molecular weight. This is normal molecular weight, normal molar mass, and by using data we can find out the abnormal molar mass, and then value of I will be calculated. So just put the formula delta TB equal to KB into M molality. Sorry, this is okay. So KB is 2.57. Molality WB by molecular weight into 1 by WA into 1000. Delta TB we have 0.36. We can find out the molecular weight. Molecular weight is 2.57. WB 1.65 by delta TB 0.36. WA is 100 into 1000. And simply calculate it. If we solve it completely, then molecular weight will come approximately 117.9 gram. Easy. So this is a abnormal molar mass. Abnormal molar mass. Again, we can find out the value of I. Here we have normal molar mass 60 gram and abnormal molar mass 117.9, round of 118 graph. As we have learned in last class, value of I is in terms of a molecular mass. I equal to normal mass by abnormal molar mass. Normal mass is acetic acid 60. Abnormal we have found 118 gram. So I here will be 60 by 120, 1 by 2 round off, so something like 0.508. 60 by 100, 0.508. This is I band of factor, and we have to find out the degree of a association also. One thing we have found out, next is degree of a association. As we know, association formula I equal alpha equal to I minus 1 by 1 by n minus 1. I we have n, here it is given acetic acid associated to form dimer, means two molecules associate together to form one molecule. So n is 2. Just simply put it here, I 0.508 minus 1 by 1 by n is 2 because it is a dimer, minus 0.492. Solve 1 by 2, 2. So if I spell it will be plus here, positive sign, 0.984%. This is alpha. We can find out the alpha percentage also. Just multiply it with 100. So we have the results. Alpha 0.508 and Gento factor 0.508 and a degree of association is 98.4%. These kind of numericals are asked in a CBSE exam. A simple thing to do numerical, just practice it. More will you explore, more will you get a confident. In description box there will be numericals, try at home. That's it for today. Thank you. And please press the bell icon for a further notification. Stay at home. Keep learning.